Hello kids, already we have discussed about countable and uncountable nouns, right? So what are countable nouns? Countable nouns means what? The nouns which can be counted. Okay, that means example are car, bus, okay, pen, pencil. So the nouns which we can count are called as your countable nouns. And the nouns which we cannot count, for example, air, okay, music, light, and water, milk, these are called as uncountable nouns, right? Now, so in the previous class, we discussed about different examples of countable and uncountable, and about some of the words which can be like articles can be used for countable noun, but only the is used for your uncountable, right? And today again we are going to discuss about some of the words which can be used for both countable and uncountable nouns. Okay, so let's see for that, and we'll go through some of the examples also. Okay, so now see here. So both countable and uncountable nouns can use this particular words. Okay, so let's see what is the first one. That is sum. Okay kids, so the word sum can be used for both countable and uncountable nouns. So the word sum. So what are the examples? Some bananas. Bananas are countable nouns, right? So some can be used for banana, that means a countable noun. And some milk. Milk is uncountable? Yes. So some can be used for both bananas and for milk also. That means the word some can be used for both countable and uncountable noun. Okay kids? Now coming to the next one, what is this? This is the a lot of. Okay, a lot of can also be used before both your countable and uncountable noun. Examples are what here? A lot of chocolates. Do you say a lot of chocolates? I want lot of chocolates, right? So chocolate is a countable noun. A lot of is used before chocolates. And another example is a lot of honey. I ate lot of honey. A lot of honey. That means what? A lot of chocolate. Chocolate is countable noun. Okay, and this is also uncountable noun. So a lot of can be used before both countable and uncountable nouns. Okay, now so coming to the next one, what can be used for both countable and uncountable noun? The word any. The word any can be used for both countable and uncountable noun, as when we are using the sentence as a question or any negative sentence. So let's go for some of the examples. Okay, now do you have any paper? Yes. Do you have any paper? Do you have any pencil? So pencil means pencil, paper, these are what your countable noun, right? So at that time we are using any. Okay, that may be a countable or uncountable. We are using any for both countable and uncountable. For example of your uncountable is what? Do you have any milk? Do we say? Do you have any milk? Yes, we say. So milk is uncountable. Paper is also paper is countable, right? So any can be used for both countable and uncountable. Okay kids? Now, so this is all about question. So in negative sentence also, when we are using the word any, that can be used for both countable and uncountable. Okay kids, so example is, you can say, yeah, okay, done, right? So there isn't any bulb. So we can say, so in negative sentence we can say there isn't any bulb. So bulb is countable, so we are using any. Again we can say there isn't any light, that means light is uncountable. So any can be used to form a negative sentence for both countable and uncountable noun. Okay kids, now we are going to discuss about the difference between countable and uncountable noun in a table. Okay, so in a table we will discuss what is the difference between countable and uncountable. Okay, so this is the summary. Now countable means countable, which we can count. Uncountable, which we cannot count. Okay, so examples are what here for countable nouns? Car, bus, pen, kid, cow, child. Okay, these all are coming under countable. Uncountable examples are what here? Water. Can we count water? No, right? So water, air, milk, etc. are your uncountable nouns. Now, so next difference is what, y'all? Countable have plural forms, right? Singular and plural, yes. So pen can be pens, cow can be cow, kid can be kids, etc. So countable nouns have plural forms, okay? But uncountable don't have plural forms, okay kids? So uncountable don't have plural forms. Examples are what, y'all? Water. Can water be waters? No, right? Can air be aids? No. Can milk be milks? No, right? So these are uncountable nouns, don't have plural forms. Okay? Now, coming to the third difference between both. The third one is what, y'all? So before your countable nouns, we use the words such as many, a few, a large, etc. Okay? So examples are what, y'all? Many apples. We use many apples, right? Now, a few roses, etc. we use. Okay? Now, before your uncountable nouns, what we use? We use much. Okay? Much air is there. Okay? Much milk is there. We say a little. Okay? A little. A little amount of water. A little amount of milk is there. So, before uncountable nouns, we use words like much, a little, a large, amount, etc. Okay? Here, we use a large number of. Here we use a large amount of. Okay. Now, examples are much water, a little milk, a large amount of water, etc. we use for your uncountable. And as I said you what? Any can be used for both countable and uncountable. And some and a lot of can also be used for both countable and uncountable nouns. Okay kids, I hope this particular thing is completely clear to you. So go through your grammar book, try to complete the exercise. Okay kids? Okay.